It was appropriate and necessary that that was, to the best of our ability, reflected in the way we describe it to ministers.
One last question on this topic, if I may. Elsewhere in your statement, and in the context of describing the how difficult it was to contemplate in January and February the notion that there might in due course have to be a full lockdown, a mandatory stay-at-home order, effectively suppressing day-to-day life and closing all high-risk, indeed every major economic and social activity. And you say this, that the absence of contemplation of that notion, of that possibility, might be considered a failure of imagination by a group of scientists who understood the nature of epidemics and their history. If anybody was going to understand the lessons to be learned from past pandemics and the necessary epidemiological lessons, it was, of course, surely the members of SAGE. What did you mean by that reference to a failure of imagination?
Well, I think that, so within SAGE, certainly I was one of the people who was most concerned that we captured the reality of previous pandemics. So let's start off with that. And for example, I was throughout, and I think this has been pointed out by some of the other witnesses, concerned about the fact that there would be a surge in winter, irrespective of where the first wave occurred. And that was partly for logical reasons, but partly because if you look back over the last, certainly over the three significant flu pandemics, for example, in the 20th century, starting with the 1918-19 one, the first wave was actually fairly moderate. And the winter surge that followed it was, in fact, killed a lot more people than the first wave. That was a really critical, in my view, fact. That wasn't picked up in the modelling, as that wasn't the reason, you know, it wasn't that the modelling couldn't pick that up, but that wasn't derived from modelling, that was derived from, in a sense, historical experience. So there's a lot of things that we could usefully pick up from previous pandemics. Secondly, within previous pandemics, a large number of NPIs had been used, and we were aware of them and modelled them, including...
Just pause there. Do you mean, is that a reference to quarantines and
self-isolation
and the like?
Exactly. Quarantines, self-isolation, school closures, stopping high-contact professions. These are things which have been done over decades or centuries. So these were mechanisms that were well known. The idea of, essentially, by law, locking down all of society is not something which had previously been used. And you could argue, and I think it is reasonable to argue, that that's something we should have cottoned onto at an earlier stage. In reality, my view is that the band of situations where that would be relevant is in fact relatively narrow. So if a pandemic was much milder, like the swine flu pandemic, then it would be seen quite reasonably as disproportionate. And if the R was, let us say, 12, rather than 3, then it would probably not be effective because the force of transmission would be too great. So
I'm going to just pause you there, please, Professor. We'll be coming back, of course, to the epidemiological justification for lockdowns in a later part of your evidence. But just on this point of principle, if there was a failure to cotton on to the notion or the possibility of a mandatory stay-at-home order, does it not necessarily follow that the government wasn't made aware in good time of that possibility, that the government wasn't advised in good enough time that this was an option, and had SAGE been alert, perhaps imaginatively, to this being a possible intervention, consideration would have been given to that possibility at an earlier and more appropriate stage?
I think what you see with SAGE, and maybe we'll come on to it later, because there's quite a lot of layers of technical points behind it, is that what SAGE was clearly advising by the time we get to the middle of March was that if ministers intended to prevent the NHS from being overwhelmed, which was one of their principal drivers, they have many others, and reduce the loss of life, they were going to have to significantly reduce interactions between households and individuals.